Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. In this video, we will work through the sample calculations to show you how to do the calculations for the solar observation project that is a part of the course. And I will work through examples of how you would go about doing those. You will be provided with some sample data within the course itself, and then that will allow you to do some of these and submit them to me in advance so that I can review and make sure that you're doing the calculations right before the final project is submitted. So let's get started. And just a little bit of a summary here as to what we're going to be doing, what is required here. So some of the requirements are that you must use the data I provide. You will see three sets of data. You will see one for spring, one for fall, and one for summer. You need not use all of these. You only need to use the one for the semester that you are taking the class. So I will let you know which one. If there are questions, feel free to ask. But if you're taking the class in the fall semester, you can use the fall data and you can completely ignore the other two. They are just there for other classes. You will need to include this data table that I provide in the final project. So you will want to include this data as well. And the graphs that I will talk about in a second video will be required to show both my data and yours on the same graph, as that is the only way to really be able to compare and to see how well you did. Now, that's what's required. Optionally, you can submit the calculations and graphs here for my data to the ungraded Dropbox that I provide within the course shell. I will look at those and give you feedback. I can let you know right now if there are issues with the calculations, if there are issues with the graphs that you may want to correct before submitting the final project. So it gives you a chance to have them looked at by me and tell you if there are any specific issues that you will want to take into account. So let's look at a sample data table here. And this is an example of what you'd see. This would be for the fall term. However, in other cases, you would simply use the other set of data. So the example I'm using is for fall. And what I've provided is a set of data taken a week apart at the assigned time. And I've got have an object height here. There's no specific units. You would want to record those in yours. You can imagine that these are all centimeters, for example, and the shadow lengths in the same set of units. Now, all the semester, you were told that you did not need to worry about this portion of the project, and that's correct. Till now. Now we're going to go through and fill out the rest of these. So I'm going to show you over the next couple slides how to fill in these last four columns, which you will need for the rest of the project. So how are we going to do those calculations? Well, you will need a scientific calculator. Those are available. Often your smartphone will have one built into it, or you can download a free one. As an app for your smartphone. If not, you can also use one that I recommend here that works out pretty well, which is an online calculator, and it's web2.0calc.com. So if you go there, you should pull up a calculator that looks much like this. You're not required to use this. Of course, if you have your own calculator that you're comfortable with, feel free to do so. It does have to be a scientific calculator, and does have to show specifically what we're looking for is the tangent function that we're going to be using. Whichever calculator you use, do make sure it is set into degree mode. If you are not in degrees, if your calculator is set into radians, for example, that will throw off the values that you get. You will get things that are incorrect. This is often a problem with graphing calculators because they are set up for mathematical work, which generally works in radians. So they will default to radians. You have to go into your settings and change them to degrees to be able to do these calculations. So this is just one example of what you would use for that calculation. So let me give you a sample calculation here. I'll put everything up on the screen and let me walk you through it briefly. Now for this one, we're going to look at the first data point that we do. The very first thing we want to do is to find the tangent of theta. That's the next column that we're looking for. So we are going to look for that next. And what you do is you take the object height that you've measured, how tall was your object, and divide it by the measured shadow length. In my case, I listed everything, my object as being 20 centimeters every time, and the shadow length for the first observation was 11.2 centimeters. If you divide those two, the units cancel, so it does not matter whether you measured in centimeters or inches or feet or light years. As long as you measured the object height and the shadow length in the same set of units, you will just get a pure number for this column. And in this case, it would be 1.79, and that is what you would put in the data table. So 1.79 would be the first number in that column that you would get. Now, once you find that, now you want to find theta. Theta is the altitude of the sun. So we want to find out how high the sun was in the sky. This is the one where you need to take the trig function. You need to take what is called the inverse tangent. So you take the number that you got here, which was the height divided by the length, and that was the 1.79, and you're going to take the inverse tangent function. This is where it is very important that your calculator be set in degrees. If you're not set in degrees, you will get a completely different value here. And in this case, you would take the inverse tangent and you would find that's not minus, that should be equals 60.8 degrees. So how high was the sun on this day? Its altitude was 60.8 degrees. Now when you do that on the calculator, let's go back and look at that. When you do that here, what you're going to use is you don't want the tangent button, you want the inverse tangent button, and that involves pushing the second button. And in the case of this online calculator, this button will change from tan to ATAN, which is the arctangent or the inverse tangent. That's correct, and that's what you want. So you'll need to push this second button first. That will change it to tangent. Then when you come back here, when you push that here, that will give you 60.8 degrees. So that's what you'd be getting for the second column that you're filling in. The third column, you want to find the declination. So this Greek letter delta is the declination of the declination of the sun on that day. That is equal to the altitude minus 49.75. This number is very specific to your location. That's what you use. Any place in the south central Pennsylvania area will be just fine. If you did make observations, you went really far south down to Florida, you went up into Canada to make observations, that number will change. But any place in this region, any place that if you're near any of the main Hack any of the Hack campuses, this number will be just fine. Unless you were hundreds and hundreds of miles north or south of this location, it really will not make any difference. So when you do that, you take the 60.8 that you just determined here, subtract that 49.75, and you find out that the declination of the sun on that day was 11 degrees. Now the last step will be to find the change in declination. In which case you do this, you take the current declination and subtract the previous one, and then divide it by the number of days between the observations. However, for this calculation, it's not applicable because we have nothing to compare it to. So let's look at one more example so we can actually go through a sample calculation of the change in declination for you as well. So sample calculation number two here is just looking at the second set of data. And what we have here, we're doing exactly the same thing. First of all, we're finding the tangent of theta. In this case, still every one of mine is 20 centimeters. This length is now 12.4 centimeters. It's gotten a little bit longer since the previous one. We divide those two and we find out that the tangent of theta is 1.61. Finding the altitude, we take the inverse tangent of that and would find 58.2 degrees. To find the declination, we take that 58.2 and we subtract 49.75 and find out that the declination of the sun is 8.45 degrees. Now we can find the change in declination. You always take the current value, the one you just got, 8.45 in this case, subtract the previous one that we calculated on the previous slide, which was 11. That gives you negative 2.55 degrees. That's how much the declination changed over the course of that week. However, while my observations are all uniformly spread out at 7 days, yours will not be. Some of your observations may only be 3 or 4 days apart, other of them might be 2 weeks apart. It just depends on when you could get your observations. So you always divide by the number of days between the observations to kind of get an average and compare how, on average, how many degrees it changed each day. So in this case, you'd take that negative 2.55. In the case of my data, you're always dividing it by 7, and you would get negative 0.364 degrees per day. Now, that is negative, and that negative sign is important because that shows that the sun was getting lower and lower in the sky. So depending on the semester you take this, you may get positive values, you may get negative values, or you may get both for my data. And that just depends on what the sun was doing over the course of that semester. When you do these calculations with your data, you will find that the change in declination number varies a lot for your data. You will see lots of errors. This is very sensitive to errors. So if you have errors in your measurements, which are expected, you will find that this number jumps around a lot, and that is perfectly fine on yours. If you're concerned about anything, of course, I'm more than happy to look at those. So let's go back for a minute here and look at our original table here, and that means we could actually fill this in a little bit, and we would find that the tangent of theta for the first one is 1.79, that theta was 60.8 degrees, the declination was 11.0 degrees, and for the second day we had 1.61, we had our altitude of 58.2 degrees, and we had our declination of 8.45 degrees, and we actually had a change in declination of minus 0.3464 degrees per day. So a little messy writing that in there. You have the numbers on the other ones, but I strongly recommend that you go through and check. Make sure you can do these calculations and get the same numbers. They may vary by one or so in the very last digit just because of rounding errors depending on how you took the numbers. That's quite fine, but if you're not getting something very close to 11 and something very close to 8.45 here, then you're likely doing something wrong in the calculations, and you're better off contacting me or redoing the calculations so that we can get them correct. Once you fill out the rest of this table, this is what you would then submit to me. And you submit that through the Dropbox, and I will be more than happy to look at it and make sure that you are doing these calculations correctly. So finishing up here, again, I've shown you how to go about doing the calculations. I do strongly recommend that you complete these early as you can, and submit them to the ungraded Dropbox. Again, that's not required. If you're perfectly comfortable doing the calculations on your own, you can submit these directly when you submit the project, and there is no deduction. This is great. Dropbox is for your help in me giving comments to you. It is not required that you use it. However, again, I do strongly advise that because it does minimize deductions. I can tell you that, hey, this would be wrong and you would lose points here when you submit the project, and you have a chance to make those corrections a little bit earlier. So that concludes this video working through how to do the calculations for the solar project for the class. I'll be back next time. I will do a video showing you how to go about getting the graphs set up for this project as well. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.